Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Okay. Okay, fine. Just raise once again those who did, because I will make those students to read so that others can listen and write it down. Anna completed. Who else? Nia completed. Anyone else? Only the
ma'am, Namasya.
Namasya. Namasya, video is here. Can't see. Where is Namasya?
Ma'am, in the top.
Yeah.
She raised.
Oh, her video is in between getting off. Okay, now I ask Nia. Nia, can you tell me table 2.1? Others, please listen and you complete it.
Okay. Name of animal, snail. Their kind of food is leaf and insects.
Please write down.
Mode of feeding is scraping.
Scraping. Okay, scraping. Scrapping. You got the word scraping down?
Okay, can you say the answer again?
Snail kind of food. Tell Nia, repeat once again for others.
Snail kind of food is leaf and insects.
Leaf and insects.
Okay.
Mode of feeding is scrapping.
Scrapping. Okay. Scrapping it up. Okay. You can write both slowly. Insects you can write. Snail eat more insects and some of the algae which is on the grass and as well as in the water. It will have some kind of plants and all things. Okay. So you can write leaf and insects. Okay. Next. And Nia and?
And kind of food is food particles.
Okay. Correct.
Mode of feeding is. And kind of food particles.
Okay.
And mode of feeding is chewing.
Yeah, chewing and chewing. Okay, Anna, next to two. Next to two, Anna will read. Okay, Nia completed two. Next to read.
Eagle, small animals.
Okay.
Mode of feeding, capturing and swallowing.
Okay, capturing is the one. Okay, capturing. So not swallowing, capturing. It will capture afterwards. It will tear it out with his beak. Okay, eagle. It may not swallow, it will spare it out. Like small chicks, small birds, and it will eat. Okay, so it will capture it and it will go and keep it on the treetop somewhere or on the rock top where there is no one, and it will tear it off and have it. So we can only write capturing, that's enough. No need of swallowing, okay? Capturing
okay,
is the mode of feeding, clear. Hummingbird.
Nectar.
Nectar.
Of flowers.
Yes. Nectar in a.
Okay, ma'am.
Mode of feeding.
Mode of feeding.
Is
sucking.
Sucking, no. Siphoning. Because the hummingbird has a very.
Can you say the spelling of siphoning?
Siphoning. It is there under that table. Can you see the word? Scraping,
yes,
chewing, siphoning. We are selecting from that words, okay?
Ma'am, so we have to write a kind of food for hummingbird as nectar.
Nectar, only nectar, because it is taking the nectar from the flowers, and some insect also it will have. Some, you know, ant will make a house and you get one kind of what you call chisel like thing.
Yes,
that
ma'am.
Also it will have.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Yes.
So you can have only nectar. Okay?
Ma'am, in the wood and all.
Wood and all that kind of things.
Ma'am, like windows,
call.
Old window.
Yeah. So that small creature over there, no? Small insect.
Yes,
worm,
ma'am.
Worms like white things. So they will eat that also. So you can write only nectar now at present. Okay. Others, not siphoning. It is not sucking. It is siphoning. Siphoning means it will drink like a juice. You know, it has got a long beak.
Ma'am,
long
like
beak,
straw.
Yeah, like a straw. Long beak, it will put that long beak in that flower and it will siphon it. It will take it the juice out of the hibiscus, shoe flower and all that. Okay, all that, clear. So next is lice. Lice, you know, what is the lice?
Ma'am, small creature in our head.
Yes, not only in our head, even on your dogs, your pet dogs and pet cats, we have a lot of lice. Lice and bugs, we call it big bugs. We call big lice, we call it bugs. Like our head, we have small bugs, so that we call lice. Okay, can you read the food? blood. What does blood? Lice will take blood. And mode of feeding?
Sucking.
That is sucking. Okay. So it will sit on our head and it will suck it up, all our blood vessels. Even dogs also, you know, big lice are there.
Excuse me, fine.
Next, Namasya. Yes, who is that?
Ananya ki vibration in the waiting
room. Yes, Vrissa?
Ananya ki vibration in the waiting room.
Okay, Namasya, you can read the remaining three.
Mosquito, blood.
Yeah, mosquito, blood. Okay, then sucking. Mosquito also blood and sucking. Okay.
Butterfly.
Butterfly. Nectar. And what is that? Siphoning. Butterfly also siphoning. With that long bone-like structure, it will suck it up. Okay. Long thorns. It has got a thorns on your face and it will suck it up.
What is the food?
Food is nectar. Butterfly, nectar. Nectar and also you can also write pollen grains if you want pollen. You know the one yellowish things on
yes,
the flowers.
Ma'am.
Oh, butterflies will eat that also. Pollens. Okay.
So ma'am, like on the flowers of hibiscus
yes,
and
yes, yes,
like
yes.
Long.
Yes, that one. Not long thing. On the top there are small yellowish pollens are there. Okay. So usually the it is the actually the productive part of the hibiscus. 1 minute. So that also we'll eat. You can write nectar. One is enough.
Mosquito same as lice, right?
Mosquito same. Blood and sucking. Housefly.
I'm almost everything.
Almost food particles. Housefly. You can write food particles.
Okay, ma'am.
Whether juice or vegetable. Siphoning. Housefly also siphoning. It won't eat, it won't chew, it will just siphon the sweet content or whatever, especially papaya and jackfruit comes, you know, this housefly will
ma'am,
like to come.
Housefly siphoning?
Siphoning. Okay, so I think everyone got it. I can ask Seba to read everything, those who came late, please.
Okay,
it's on page number, table. Page number 11, there's a table 2.1. I told you do. So, Seba, you read all that. Those who came late for the class, okay? Just read.
Three kind of food, leaf and leaf.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes?
Ma'am, for mosquito, it is siphoning or sucking?
Sucking. Mosquito will sit and they suck. And some there are different types of mosquito. If you just take it, they do both. Siphoning as well as sucking also.
Ma'am, because mosquitoes also have a long...
Yes.
Ma'am, can you see the kind of food and mode of eating butterfly?
Butterfly nectar. You write nectar. That is more majority butterfly eat nectar. Okay.
Ma'am, what is the mode of feeding?
Amount of feeding, butterfly also siphoning.
Siphoning.
Thank you. Ma'am,
okay, can you...
You start from the beginning, okay? Yes.
Snail. Kind of food is leaf and small insect. Mode of food is scraping.
Scraping.
And kind of food is food particles and mode of feeding is chewing. Hummingbird.
Eagle. Before that, eagle is there.
Yeah, sorry, ma'am. Eagle. Small birds and
animals, small animals also sometimes.
Small animals and capturing. Hummingbird, nectar and siphoning.
Lice. Siphoning.
Lice, blood and sucking. Mosquito, blood and sucking. Butterfly, nectar and siphoning. Housefly, food particles and siphoning.
Okay. Housefly can be sucking also. We can write both for housefly also because housefly sometimes it will just sit on the jackfruit when we cut they come there and they will just sit on that they will suck it up the sweet taste from the jackfruit so that is also
ma'am in housefly can we write almost everything
housefly we can write not almost everything you can write sucking and siphoning we can write. Both we can write. Okay, siphoning
no, and sucking. Kind of food. Kind of food.
Food particles. Because whether it's a juice or that, it will come. If it is curd, also housefly will come. So you already know. So food particles and sucking or siphoning. Both we can do.
Siphoning spelling is
S-I-P-H. Fawning you do. With the fawning, we will write as C-S-I. So siphoning. That is the word we use for drinking juice through straw. That is the action we call. Instead of saying drinking juice through straw, we can say simple word siphoning. Okay. Why you know? Siphon is a, in physics, siphon is used for a tube-like structure which can be used to collect the gases and all that in some of the experiments. So that's where the word is come from, that one. That one is known as siphon. So the word is come from siphoning. Okay, so shall we go to the next thing?
Yes, ma'am.
Type of teeth. I think majority knows the type of teeth. Correct? Even you don't do also, you can tell me that answer because we already discussed that. Okay? Brisa, can you tell me table 2.2, page number 13, first one? So those who did not complete, you can tick on it. Type of teeth. Please read. Already we discussed in the last class. How many numbers are each one? Now also those who look at that picture on your textbook, you will be able to understand the answers.
Cutting and biting. Lower jaw, upper jaw and total.
How many numbers, dear? Lower jaw? I think your sound is breaking, Vrissa. Cutting and biting teeth. Which teeth it is, dear?
Ma'am, can I? Ma'am, can I?
Incisor. Are you saying incisor?
Yes, ma'am.
I can get your lip movement, but your sound is some echoing. Okay. Okay. Correct. Okay. Fidel, can you tell me? Again, repeat that cutting and biting teeth. What
ma'am,
type of
incisor.
Teeth? Incisor, lower jaw, how many incisors we have? Write the number over there. Lower jaw, how many incisors?
Four.
Okay. Four. Upper jaw?
Ma'am, four.
Total? Total?
Eight.
Okay, fine. Eight. Correct. Eight. Okay. Yes. Ayan, can you tell me next one?
I didn't complete.
You didn't complete? You can give me the answer, no? You were there in the last class. Okay, yeah. Say.
Piercing and tearing teeth.
Which teeth it is?
And premolar.
Piercing and tearing?
Canine.
Yes, canine. Okay.
And two.
Two. Where?
Lower
jaw, how many?
And two.
Is it two? Yes, lower jaw, both sides we have two. Okay. Two. Remaining upper jaw also?
Two.
Total?
Four.
Okay, fine. Next, we move on to Sri Lakshmi. Can you tell me? Last one.
Chewing and grinding teeth.
Which teeth it is?
Premolar.
Premolar plus molar. Both are. You can say both because both are have the same function. Okay. So premolar and molar. Total, tell me how many in premolar and molar altogether?
Ma'am, lower jaw 10, upper jaw also 10.
Okay.
Ma'am,
total
20.
24 plus?
So we get 20.
24 plus 8. Total how much we got it?
Ma'am, 32.
32. Got it? Okay.
Ma'am, 32.
Yes. Okay, children. So we have almost completed the function of buccal cavity.
Ma'am.
And there is one activity we need to discuss. That is what we are moving on to. Activity. So before that, let me open the easy board. Activity 2.3. So there's an activity in your textbook 2.3. So which part of the buccal cavity has salivary glands? Can you tell me which part of the buccal cavity has salivary glands?
Ma'am, the lower part of buccal cavity.
Yes. Okay. No. Lower part. Full buccal cavity. Our outer part of the buccal cavity. It is actually the mouth. No. Full. That part is buccal cavity is almost the structure of the buccal cavity. We call it mouth. Correct. Correct. And what is the other parts of the buccal cavity? This one. Tell who is the Steve. Can you tell me other parts of the buccal cavity? Teeth already discussed.
Tongue.
And what else? Yeah. What else?
Taste buds.
Ma'am,
teeth, tongue, taste buds.
Taste buds. Okay, correct. Okay.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes. Tell me.
Ma'am, does our teeth, gums, come in the buccal cavity?
Yes, but we don't call it because gums are just act like muscles. So muscles are very common in our body. So each part that muscles we call it is different name. So gum, we cannot say it's a part. It is a part of a muscular system. Clear? So that is why. What is the function of the gums? You know what is the function of the gums?
No, ma'am.
Gums do? Gums is holding the teeth tight to our mouth.
Okay. The screen is not
visible. Holding the teeth stronger and making us to bind inside the mouth. So that is the gum. So once gum weakens, what will happen? Your teeth started coming out. Okay. So that is the reason sometimes we are telling the children avoid more Coca-Cola like drinks as well as the chocolates. We can have the chocolates, but not much, because if you going to be continue eating for long time, there are some chemical content in chocolates and as well as all the drinks, Coca-Cola, Miranda and all, made up of carbolic acid. Carbolic acid is a chemical acid which is not good for our health. So once in a while you can have. Nowadays, even parents are not bothering. They just give a newborn baby. Newborn baby means maybe 1 year child. They will give Coca-Cola to drink. Actually, they are just killing that baby actually. See, we have a strong immune system in our body. But a child between 1 year and 5 year old, maybe their child may be crying. But some of the parents now what they do, they will give the Coca-Cola and all, make them to stop crying. So that is actually they are killing that baby. After some time, what they do know? Their own children will have some health issues. Maybe some kind of diseases or something and all. Or then their bones become weak. So this kind of things are reasonable. So now you all are now old enough. If you have a sibling at home, if they are crying for this kind of things, you have a responsibility that to just control that. Okay. You also must, some of you must have liking that Coca-Cola and Miranda every now and then. That is addiction, no? Just like how we addict to alcohol. It's just like an addiction for everyone. But that is actually making your gums to decay, your teeth to decay, even your bones to decay. So it has been proved. It has been proved by the scientist. Even you keep one piece of maybe one small tooth, you put it in Coca-Cola, in one glass tumbler of Coca-Cola. You just wait and see after 2-3 days, you will not see the tooth in the Coca-Cola. There are, you can do it. Suppose someone's milk teeth is coming out, you think about it and then put it in glass tumbler, put Coca-Cola and pour it and keep. Within 2-3 days, you just wait, go and see. You see whether you can see your tooth over there. Okay. You all are laughing, but this is the truth. Okay. So gums are very tender. They are very soft. So this carbolic acid first make the gums to decay. Suddenly gums started decay. Naturally, what happened? The tooth starts falling down or happen. Clear? Okay. Yes. Now, did we discuss about nutrition in starfish?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, just like a buccal cavity, since we are discussing buccal cavity, we are now in that same, you can see it in your textbook, page number 12, regarding amazing fact. Okay. This is something which is very beautiful feature of a starfish. When you look at the starfishes are just like one star-like structure. But you forget about the starfish also is having its stomach and digestive system.
Ma'am. Ma'am, a starfish has only like muscles in its body. It does not have bones.
It does not have bones, but it has its own digestive system, a peculiar digestive system. If you look at the starfish over here, you will see that it is an, when you just observe the starfish on the beach, you will see some of the starfishes are all on the beach shore, little purple color and all. Actually, their digestive system actually at the center of their body. When you look at it, you don't see it. But if you closely look at there, the starfish, as they move, there is a small mouth opening at the stomach, at the center. Okay. So, starfish feeds on hard shells of calcium carbonate. Hard shells of calcium carbonate. Hard shells of calcium carbonate. You know the shellfish? You have eaten shellfish, no? Some of you. Shellfish means what?
Oyster. And crab.
Not prawns.
And crab.
Crab.
One minute. Some of other students are joined. Let me security. Okay. Some sounds. Fine. Tell me.
Oyster.
Oyster is another type of a shellfish.
Crab.
We get a kakkarchi. Have you heard about kakka?
Yes, ma'am.
That is a shellfish. Oyster is not available for all the seasons. But you know the shellfish which we have it. Okay, that white thing, color things. So that is actually is the shellfish. So actually, this starfish is having that shellfish as its food. Okay, what it does, it go and sit on the one of the shellfish and break open the shell of that. And once it break open, it will open its stomach. So it pops out its stomach through mouth to eat the soft animal inside the shell. So what it will do? The starfish pops out its stomach through mouth. So here is the mouth at the center of his body.
Ma'am.
Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, like this one, right?
This one?
Ma'am, can you see?
Where? Who is showing that?
Ma'am, Smriti.
Okay. Yes.
On the center, there is mouth.
That is the thing. Have you, everyone can see what Smriti is showing?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We can see.
Okay. So, usually the starfish, if you look at on the beach shore, it will be seen like that. So, you can see center that stomach. So it will be open. The mouth is on this center, and it opened. Once it opened the mouth, just like a stomach will come out. Okay, stomach will come out. Suppose this is the shellfish over there. Stomach will come out, and it will break open that shell, and then just pick it up that flesh. What you have? What we also have? The flesh of that shellfish. We take the flesh and swallow it, and then close it. Once the stomach take that shellfish into the mouth, slowly, what will happen? Its mouth closes also. So when you look at the starfish, you never see its mouth under very clearly. You have to closely watch it, what it does. The reason is that you are only seeing the outer part. Their mouth is other side because they are moving like this, no? On the sand, they are moving. So their mouth will be just facing the sand. So we will see only the outer part. We don't see it is opening the mouth and eating the calcium carbonate and all those things. Okay. So this shellfish are plenty calcium, and we also use the shells of this shellfish as the manure or fertilizer. We will use the shells of that shellfish as a manure to improve the nutrients for the plants. That is it's very useful. Shellfish is very useful. We can also have it. We can also use the shellfish as the manure. So this is the starfish. Feeds on animals covered by hard shells of calcium carbonate. After opening the shell, the starfish pops out its stomach through its mouth to eat the soft animal inside the shell. Okay, Aldous, can you read that? What do you see on that?
Yes, ma'am.
Read.
Starfish feeds on animals covered by hard shells of calcium carbonate. After opening the shell, the starfish pops out its stomach through its mouth to eat the soft animal inside the shell. The stomach then goes back into the body and the food is slowly digested.
Okay, children, this you have to study not for the periodic test one. If you have descriptive exam in term one, we will have a paragraph question like that. Explain the nutrition in starfish. And for MCQ one, what we have to study? The name of calcium carbonate. Okay.
So we have to write this in the lecture note?
No need, no need. You can study from the textbook. Okay. So starfish feeds on animals covered by hard shells of calcium carbonate.
We have studied calcium carbonate in snails last year.
Snail. So snail also is an animal. It's a marine species which have plenty of calcium. Okay. Even our sardines, you know, the matti also contain a plenty of calcium. It's good for our bones. That's why. Very good for our bones. Clear. Okay, fine. Next, we move on to next section. One activity I told you, we have some activity to discuss. How to find out the presence of starch. Okay. So this is our experiment. This is also, you have to understand it. For MCQ questions, we can just ask the color of what the effect of that, what is the main product of that activity. After explaining, I will tell you what we have to learn from this. Okay. So experiment to show the effect of saliva on starch. So we have to test it, whether the food, what you have, whether there, what is the effect of saliva on starch. Okay. We have already learned. What is the use of saliva? What's the use of saliva? I can ask.
Ma'am, saliva is mixed with the food to make it, to break the food.
And break it down.
To make it soft.
That is break down the complex substances into simpler ones. So whenever we have the rice, what do we have? Of the saliva, we mix it with the rice and we chew it and then it will turn into the form of a paste. So we have to check whether whether there is a presence of saliva on the food what we take. So for that, the first step means we take two test tubes. They're labeled as A and B. Two test tubes which will be, sorry, we labeled as A and B. In test tube A, 1 teaspoon full of boiled rice was kept. We will take in one test tube A, boiled rice, we take it. In test tube B, 1 teaspoon full of boiled rice, which were chewed for 3-5 minutes. That is, you take little rice. You can do it at home. Okay, I'll tell you how to do that. So take two vessels, two tumblers. If you don't have test tube, you can have two tumblers. In one tumbler, you take the rice, okay, and keep inside. Another tumbler, you take the rice, you chew it little bit, and then you put it in that. Okay, afterwards, you should wash the tumbler neatly, okay, because you will be using for drinking. Okay, so for the experiment, you can make use of it. Then what you should add, we have to add 3 to 4 ml of water to both of the tubes. We just put some water over it. Then afterwards, what does we do? Do you have the ointment at home, Betadine? Have you heard about an ointment?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
For what we are using that Betadine?
For
it will heal the wound.
Yes. When you get a cut and all, if you put that Betadine into it, you will get cured. Okay. So the cut will get cured. So actually, it is a content of iodine in that. So since we don't get iodine solution as such as at home, you can take this Betadine, little bit ointment of the Betadine, and you mix in this water, both the water. Then once you mix that in the water, what you will see? In one of the test tube A, it will show a blue black color. The rice and the water will be turn into little more black and with a little bluish color. Together you will get a color, blue black color. But test tube B, which already you chewed and kept there, it doesn't show any color. It become colorless. Okay, so the blue black color will tell you that the starch is present over there, while test tube B will show that the starch is already broke down. Starch already broke down into sugar. So this is the picture of that test tube. If you do it, you can see that here it is kept boiled rice. Here also chewed boiled rice. We are putting iodine solution into it. And pure iodine solution will have little bit of violet color. But betadine don't have much violet color because it is a compound of other things. So you don't get a pure iodine solution in that. Yes, Smriti.
Can we do this activity in, is it compulsory to do it in test tube?
No, not compulsory. I told you, no, take a glass tumbler or something if you want. Okay. It's not compulsory. It's not compulsory for you to do it in the test tube. This is, we are doing in the lab, chemical laboratory, because it's a part of chemistry. We do it. Okay. Since we don't have test tube at home, we can do it at home. But you see, the pure iodine solution will have get little purple color. But betadine may not have little purple color because it is the compound of some other. We mix with iodine and some other thing in that. Okay.
Ma'am, is betadine same as like Dettol and all?
Ma'am, this is betadine, right?
It's an ointment. Ointment just like your toothpaste. You will able to buy it. You get it. And Dettol may contain iodine. You just try. Just try. Because Dettol also you are using to clean the wound, no? So what you do, yes, if you have a Dettol, just try whether we success or
not. Happy betadine.
Okay. Otherwise, use the betadine. Clear? So betadine, if you use it here, what happened? The black blue color or blue black color indicates the presence of starch in the food. But second test tube, already you have chewed and kept it. What will happen? It will not have starch. What happened? The saliva already broke that starch into glucose, other content. Just like that only it goes to in your stomach. It won't, when you chew it, already the starch has been broken down and it will turn into glucose and it will reach to the other parts of the body. Okay, so this is how we can do the activity. So you try. Those who have Dettol, those are Dettol, just try. We can try because experiment scientists are not born within one day, correct?
How many drops of water should be?
Water may not be much. You see the test tube, they put a little, very little water, not much. Okay,
ma'am.
Okay. You first put little, only just think that the boiled rice should be drowned in the water, that much. Boiled rice should be drowned in the water.
And that means it should be in the bottom of the...
Maybe one fourth of the test tube. That may be... okay.
Ma'am, so how much we have to add the iodine solution?
If you have iodine solution, you can add 2-3 drops. When you add itself, you will see the color is changing little bit. So if you add more iodine solution, maybe the color will become little more dark. Okay. Those are adding Dettol, just try. But I'm not sure what is the compound of Dettol. Whether Dettol contain iodine, I don't know. But you just try whether we can get it or not. Clear?
Okay.
So this is the effect of saliva on starch. So saliva can break down the starch into glucose. So by doing this, you will understand that after chewing, presence of saliva make the starch content in your food will be broke down into glucose. Clear? Okay, children.
Clear, ma'am.
So yes. I think by now almost time up. I just wind up the session for you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Do we have one more class? No.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
So only next one class, Monday, come prepare for your class test up to buccal cavity. whatever we learned from this chapter. Okay, first chapter only this chapter. Okay, and Sri Rudra, Sri Lakshmi, just prepare for your seminar once again because we did not do your seminar so far. Clear? Okay. Okay. Thank you, children. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.